We can learn from sports. We can learn from people who've made it to the top of their game. And this study came up with five fundamental principles of why these people became champions, and I hope that it's something that you can apply to your lives and to your businesses. So principle number one is the winners play the conventional game well. What does that mean? Each of your businesses has a game, a conventional way to play the game. In my world, in fast food consumer goods, the game has three parts. Good product, win in store, market the heck out of it. Those are the fundamentals, that's the game of winning in FMCG. Now, every business has a different game, every sport has a different game. The winners at least know how to play that game quite well. But the champion is completely different. The champion innovates and changes the whole game. And if you look at our life for a minute, if you think about things in our life, think about what Apple and the iPhone did to companies like Nokia. I remember when Nokia, everybody had a Nokia phone. Now I don't know anyone who has a Nokia phone. The second principle is winners, they take risks. But they're also the kind of folks that are always acknowledging reality. So you give them a big number, they're in sales. You say, I need you to hit this number this year. And they say, okay, I'll try. But then they come back to me and say, boss, I've got to be honest with you. We've got to deal with reality. I'm not going to make it. We're never going to make that number. We'll try, but I need to be blunt with you. We're not going to make it. These people, again, win on a very inconsistent basis. What the champions do is they take enormous risks to go for breakthrough. And the word is impossible. It is not their vocabulary. Principle number three, winners win and then they party. They party hard. They let go of the gas. They live on the past. I had a distributor once in the Philippines. He wasn't doing very well. I gave him a year. He gave lots of feedback. At the end, I said, I'm going to fire him. So I fired the guy. This is 2008. He comes to me, calls me up. He says, I'm going to fly to Manila. I need to see you. I said, bring it. Bring it on. You can come and talk to me. So he comes and talks to me, brings his briefcase, opens his briefcase, and he pulls out this plaque. And it's a framed certificate. And inside it says, P&G Distributor of the Year 1992. I said, wow, congratulations. He goes, but there's more. And I said, okay. He pulls out a second plaque. And it says, P&G Distributor of the Year 1997. And then he looks up at me and he says, I'm a two-time P&G Distributor of the Year. You can't fire me. And I said, my friend, that was 11 years ago. And it's always interesting. Athletes never act like this. Can you imagine Usain Bolt going to the Olympic Committee right now saying, look, I got a proposition for you. I won in 2008 Beijing gold medal. I won in 2012 in London gold medal. I won in 2016 in Rio the gold medal. Let's not run the 100 meters in 2020. Just give me the gold medal now. Success is never owned, it's rented. And the rent is due every day. The champion wins, then the next day they're in the weight room working out. They have one bad meal, and then in the meal after that, they're back on the diet. The winner will party for weeks and months. The champion's back on their game the next day. The principle number four is, winners are good at the fundamentals of whatever they do. So my business with the fundamentals involve good writing, good financial skills, ability to look at advertising. These are all the fundamentals. And the winners of my organization are good at the fundamentals. But the true champions go way beyond good. They master the fundamentals. The final principle has been considered by all to be the most important one of all. You see these people, they get interviewed. They're in the Wimbledon final for the first time. And they're being interviewed on TV and they say, it's just such an honor to be here. I don't really care what happens tomorrow. I'm just so excited to be able to play on center court and to be in this final and to say I made the Wimbledon final. 99% of the time, that person will lose. The winner is happy to be in the final. They always think about next year. Maybe next year. Maybe next Olympics. They don't win. They don't win. What the champion has is this concept called sense of the historic. Sense of the historic is the recognition of the greatest moments in our lives when we can't fail.